Lucky was telling me that I was with Justin Timberlake.
Really?
Yeah.
He has curly blonde hair.
Justin Timberlake? No, he don't. No, he's got straight hair, I think. He's got brown hair. I told him, I said, if anything, he looks like me because I'm older than he is. Are you talking or are you laughing?
You kidding me? Do you think the pedophile motherfucking piece of shit?
Ring, 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 that's ring, 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 banana phone.
You're fucking bullshitting me. I'm
ring,
fucking,
ring, 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 banana
phone.
I've got this feeling.
You need a goddamn answer. And you're my girlfriend, and you don't see what's wrong with giving somebody else my baby.
What is your suggestion that you and I do?
Just be fun. Just be really, you know. Just be friends. I think that will show your probation officer and your counselor that you're taking great strides in your recovery, because it'll enable you to say, hey, you know, I have this person who's a female friend, and I'm not trying to be, you know, anything more than just friends with her. And meanwhile, I'm dating this person face to face or whoever, and it's gone really well. And whenever I need a little bit of advice, I can call my friend Elizabeth or Ramona, whatever they call me. And she helps me out. She gives me advice, and things are going really well with April or Ashley or whoever from Circle K or whatever. But I think that will be really helpful for you.
And you'll be able to keep Corey.
Say again?
And you'll be able to keep Corey.
That too, but I mean, I think for you, it'll be really helpful in your recovery for them to see that you are with someone who is face-to-face, who lives with you. They can live with you, or they could live in the same state as you, but who lives in your area face-to-face. But not only that, that you are taking strides and that you're able to have a platonic friend as well as having a face-to-face relationship. I think that's going to really impress them.
So in other words, you want Corey and not me.
I want you to be happy, and I want you to be able to be face-to-face. I want you to have someone who is right there with you.
I want to be able to, for us to be right there with each other.
But what's most likely is for right now, you're going to be able to find someone who is face-to-face with you. And I think that's really, I think that in your recovery, because I have a couple friends who, real therapists, and I have a, she's a real therapist. And she trains people. She works in Virginia. She lives in Virginia. She trains people. She coaches people on this kind of stuff. And I saw her a couple days ago, and I just kind of told her a little bit about the situation as if it were coming from, as if somebody else had told me. But you and I are living in different states, and you can't leave your state. And so I think for you, it would be really helpful if you found someone there.
I can't leave my state yet. If you were to come up here and meet me face to face, then they would allow me to go down there.
But here's the thing, though. That can't happen right now. And what I want for you
Because of Corey, right?
It's about you and getting yourself together and what I want.
Listen, how long have you and Corey been together? 5 years.
Listen.
Wow.
Listen. You deserve respect. Listen.
How do you feel about me? How do you honestly feel about me?
I want you to be happy.
No, that's not what I'm saying. I want to know how you honestly feel about me.
Listen, it's not right for you to have to want someone who's in a different state.
I want you to be honest with me.
I respect you.
You what?
I respect you, and I care about you, and I want you to have someone who is face-to-face with you.
You feel as much for me as you do for it.
Lauren, you should have someone who is...
I want to answer that question.
What do you want me to say?
I want the honest truth.
I'm giving it to you, and you're fighting me with it.
I'm not fighting you with it. I want to know. You care about me more than Corey, or care about me less than Corey? I want to know.
That's not a right question, because one person...
It is a right question. It is a right question for me. 9 months. I deserve to know the answer.
And I've been with him for 5 years.
Tell me. Now I have to waste 9 months of my life.
I'm telling you that this is going to help you with them. Listen to me. This is going to help you with them.
This is not going to help me.
It is. Listen.
Do you think the last 9 months has helped me?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
You're in love with somebody else, and you're not in love with me. The 9 months of my life was wasted thinking that you wanted me. You tell me how that helped me.
Are you drinking?
I'm not drinking. I'm laying in bed.
No. I mean, that's one way in which you've been helped.
Because somebody called that and had called for a welfare check on me that night at 2:00 in the morning. You know who that was?
I have no clue who that was.
You're in love with Corey. That's good for me.
Oh, hey, this is not how I thought this was going to go.
How'd you expect it was going to go? 9 months of my life was wasted on somebody that played a game with me. That I gave all everything to. Did you really think that was fun? Did you really think I deserve that?
Hold on. Okay, I'm back. Like I said, I think that you will benefit from having friends and from being with someone who's in your area. And the best thing I can do is help you with that, which I'm offering to do. And
what you wanted to do is you wanted to keep me in your life, so you constantly know about me and everything that's going on.
No, that's not it at all. You know what? If you don't, hey, you know what? If I, let's say a week from now, a month from now, I call you and I say, hey, how are you doing? You don't want to tell me what's going on in your life. That's fine. You don't have to.
You went four days and then you called.
No, seriously. You don't have to.
Seriously, you tell me how right any of this shit that you've done has benefited me.
Because I am the only person who has ever sat down for 5, 6, 7, 8 hours at a time and talk to you through your problems. And you've admitted that several times.
You're also the only person that has played with me for 9 months and the whole time has lied to me about everything, including that you have been living with boyfriend and girlfriend with this guy that you're living with. And tell me that he's your brother. And playing all these other fucking games of demo. And I give you my everything. And don't even fucking look at other women.
So
you really want me to be happy about that shit?
Are you
hearing anything that you're saying?
I am offering to help you so that you can please your probation officer and you can please your counselor and you can get through your class. I'm offering to help you.
This is something else that you have to listen to. Right now, you said, right now I can't go down there. What the hell difference does it make? If I go down there at all, if you have a boyfriend for 5 years that you say you're in love with. Obviously, you must not be in love with him if you want me to go down there. Am I right?
I want you to be able to be happy with someone who is right there with you.
Answer my question, please. Am I right?
What is the question?
Are you in love with him, or aren't you in love with him? I want an honest answer.
That has nothing to do with this.
It has everything to do with it.
It doesn't, because I'm different. It does not, because what I'm saying would apply even if he didn't exist, even if I had never met him. What I'm saying to you is that...
What you're saying is I can't go down there right now, so you want to keep Corey. You say you're in love with him, but that doesn't show a sign of love. That shows a sign of convenience.
Oh, boy.
Didn't realize I was this intelligent, huh?
No, it's not that at all. I'm again, the expression olive branch comes into mind. I'm extending another one.
How much do you care about me?
A lot. I mean, I do.
Like how much?
You know, I mean, I feel for you for things that you've experienced. I mean,
how much do you feel for me as a person that you've gotten to know?
I think you're a nice person. I do. And you know, I think that one day you can be really happy if you continue to take my advice.
Love for me. You know that I was asking that question. So I'll come right out and ask it. Do you feel any love for me?
I think that comes from I think that comes from really getting to know someone, and
you don't think you did that?
And
I gave you a real ring.
And I think that you could greatly benefit from having a friend and from
you're not answering my question. Would you stop going around my question? Do you feel any love?
You deserve more than what I feel.
I want to know feel.
You deserve more than what I feel.
You're going around.
A little bit.
You do feel love for me.
A little bit.
What do you think about that when you have face to face?
Say again?
What do you think about that when you met me face to face?
I can't hear you. Hello?
Hey, where are you? Oh, I'm here. Can you hear me?
Yes.
What do you think about that when you met me face to face? When you have any met face to face?
I think that you deserve more, and I think that you could have more. I just think that you need to trust that you can and look for that in other places.
I think you're trying to find an easy way out.
Boy. And what do you think?
What do I think?
Yeah, go ahead with what you were going to say.
I think it's because we're a distance apart. You're trying to find an easy way out so you can try to get rid of the love that you have for me so you can continue loving Tori. Which doesn't really even sound like you're in love with.
Here's the thing, okay? Um, who I love isn't something that you should worry about. What you should worry about is finding someone who's there, finding someone who can be there for you. That's what you should focus on.
I found somebody that can be there for me.
But I can't, that's the thing. I can't. And
you can't be here permanently right now.
But
that doesn't mean you can't come up, see me face to face, so that they can allow us to continue. But that would also mean that you would have to get rid of Corey. And that's what you have a problem with, because you've been with him for 5 years and it's convenient because he's there. And you're used to him. Problem is now you're used to me too. And that's why you feel love for me, because you're not in love with him.
Lorne, that is, no, Lorne, listen to me.
Am I really far off? It sure doesn't sound like I am.
I'm a really nice person. I mean, I really am. And it's not in my nature to hurt people. It's not in my nature to make people angry. That's just never been a part of who I am. And I've always wanted to help people. And I would like to help you. I mean, I think that the best thing for you to do, the thing that would make you the happiest, is to be with someone who you don't have to convince. That they want you.
That you have to convince that they want you?
To be with someone who...
You mean that it gives you attention?
To be with someone who is right there, who you don't have to convince that they're in love with you, and I would be happy to help you with that. I really would.
I don't like to hurt people. Look at what you got.
I did not... You accused me of playing games with you for 9 months. I did not do that. And I'm certainly not doing...
What would you call it? If you didn't play games with me for 9 months, then you really thought just as well as I did. We were a real thing. Well, at the same time, that boy right there.
But what you should want, who is right there, who you and hey, you know, we were establishing a friendship, and I would be happy to hear that you.
You want me to have someone that's right here? Get up here.
Oh, listen to me, please. I would be happy to hear that you went on a date and you had a really nice time. I would be happy to hear stuff like that. I would be happy for you, things like that to happen. Because I certainly don't want you to think that now you shouldn't date people or anything, or that women are going to hurt you. I just think that you would be so much happier if you didn't have to, if you weren't trying to create something with someone who you have to convince. I've never made romantic advances towards you.
Oh, my God.
I don't want you to
If you don't think you played a game with me for 9 months, you tell me what you did.
We were establishing a friendship, and now, you know what? I think that it would be great for you.
We were establishing a friendship.
Listen to me.
I was telling you I loved you all. I was calling you baby all.
Listen,
I was telling you things and I didn't tell anybody. I was closer to you than I was close to anyone.
Listen to me. You've told me before that you have, I don't know if romantic interest or people right there. Someone who works at the Circle K, someone who's at Walmart, who's right there and can really make you happy. You have to go to Applebee's with someone who's right there. That's the kind of stuff that you should be doing.
Are you married?
What?
Are you married?
No, I'm not. And I never have been. But that's not the point. The point is that I think that...
Are you another parent?
Lord, this has nothing to do with
that. It does. I want to know. Are you in love with Tori?
What matters is not how I feel about him. What matters is how I feel about you.
Listen, you are going around my question again. Would you stop doing that? Like, my questions are important, you know. I'm not asking them just to ask them.
Why does it matter how I feel about people and anything like that? If I'm telling you what I think for you and what I think, what I personally think I can do to help you and what I think would be best for you.
Are you in love with Tori?
Lauren, listen to me. Lauren, listen to me.
Just tell me yes or no.
My answer to that is notwithstanding. I want to say this, okay?
It is for me.
Okay, listen, I want to say this, okay?
Obviously, you're not in love with him, otherwise you would pop out, yeah.
Lauren, the worst thing that a person can do is give their heart to someone and they don't know if it's going to be. They don't know this person in the true sense of the word, right? Because here's the thing, when you know someone and when you truly know someone, you have to wonder if they're real. You don't have to wonder if they're playing. You don't have to wonder if they're going to hurt you. That is the person who you give your heart to. You don't give it to people over the internet because they're nice. What you should have given me is exactly what I wanted and is what I still wanted. And what is that? I wanted to be nice to you. I wanted to be your friend. I wanted to be a kind person.
Yeah, well, you didn't quite go all that way.
I feel like everything I say is falling on deaf ears because I'm not saying exactly what you want me to say. And I feel like...
You feel like what?
I said, I feel like everything I'm saying is falling on deaf ears because I'm not saying exactly what you want me to say.
Maybe yeah. Just because I can't fucking believe this shit. That's fucking blowing my mind.
Listen to me.
After 9 months, you really want me to just say, gee, that's okay. I agree, that's okay.
No, that's not what I want you to say. What I want you to say is that you'll give it a chance. What I want you to say is that you will consider what I'm saying to you. Think about this, okay? Take this to your therapist. Tell your therapist that Ramona or Elizabeth, whatever she calls me, tell her that I said, that I want to be your friend and I'll be there for you and give you advice and be a nice person to you. But that in the future, I told you that you should not be giving your heart away to people just because they're nice to you. And you shouldn't expect the world from someone who truly does not know you, who has not been with you face to face to get to know you on a deeper level. I guarantee she'll agree with me.
And at the same time, you want me to expect to just be all right with a thought in my head that, you know, when I talk to you, she's else, sleeping with someone else, having sex with someone else, after 9 months of thinking it was just me and you.
Say again? You cut out for a minute.
I said, and you want me to be all right with talking to you on the phone all the time, and all the time in my mind, I'm thinking that she's living with someone else, sleeping with someone else, having sex with someone else, and spending time with someone else. After nine months of thinking it was just me and you.
It's a trapping feeling, because here I am. I was trying to be nice, and I was being your friend and whatnot, and it's like all of a sudden one day you tell me that you're in love with me, and I did not think that anything that I did warranted response.
Me telling you that I weren't in love with you?
Yeah, because I think that that should be reserved for someone who is right there, who's able to give you everything that you want and everything that you deserve.
I'm floored that you think that I should just say, gee, this is all right. This is such a good idea.
I think that you will see in time that it is. I really and truly do. I think that you will see in time that it is.
I want you to answer my question. Yes or no answer. Are you in love with Corey?
Listen to me. The reason why I have not answered that is because it has nothing to do with this.
Everything to do with you and me. Are you in love with him?
Please stop. Listen. Everything that I am saying to you. Or, I'm sorry.
I don't know why you think my question is important.
The thing that's upsetting to me about that question is that there's no right answer in this situation. And that's why I'm saying to you.
An honest answer is what I want.
Listen to me. I don't think that we need to discuss that. What we need to discuss is how I can be a good friend to you and how I can help you so that you can move through your therapy and your probation. I feel that I should give you that. And I will.
And another problem is they don't want me talking to anybody from the internet. That's another problem.
We don't have to talk every day.
The phone even. Anybody from the internet. They don't want me talking to anybody from the internet.
Listen, what you should strive for, don't even think about that right now. What you should be striving for, what you should be striving for is to find someone who is, I mean, obviously I agree that age is just a number, but I think that you would have an easier time relating to someone who's around your age, because they'd be in the same phases of life that you are, but certainly someone who is within a 100-mile radius. Someone who you can go on dates with. And I don't know if anybody ever told you these things before. So I'm telling you. Someone who you can go on dates with. Someone who you can take to the movies. Someone who can come over and watch with you. Someone who you can cook dinner for. Someone who you can walk your dogs together. And I think that you can find that. And I've encouraged you to find that several times within the last 9 months. I really have. I think that that's going to be...
In the last 2 months, you have.
Even before that, I would say stuff like that. Because here's the thing, though. You're always going to wonder, right? And that's not going to be fun. You're always going to wonder. If you're with someone who is safe away from you, you're always going to wonder how dedicated they are, if they're seeing someone else. Those things are never going to leave your mind. But what you've got to do is you've got to become comfortable with being uncomfortable.
You always have contact with me.
Say again?
Yes, friendship thing. You'll always have contact with me. I won't be out of your life.
I'd like that. But, I mean, I really would like that.
I mean, not to be out of your life. I know.
I enjoy talking to you. I would like that.
I know. We enjoy talking to each other. We enjoy spending time with each other. That's why we eat 10, 12 hours, sometimes even 14 hours a day.
I like that. And you know what?
I think they help quite a bit.
You know what? I like that. And I'll tell you, I've told people who have, because I seriously have told a lot of people that. And I do enjoy that. And I think that that's nice. And in that time, I can give you advice. I can say things to you that can help you. And people have asked me why I did that. Why I invested that kind of time trying to help you. And my thing is, and you've even asked that. And my thing is people have done it for me. So I don't mind doing it for someone else. People have sat down with me for hours and hours and given me advice, and I don't mind passing it forward. But what I want for you and what you should want is you should want someone who's right there, who's able to make you happy, and who you don't have to worry about. And I
really love Victoria. I want you to answer me.
Oh, God, Lauren, please, listen. This is about you, and I want to talk to you, okay? Okay, listen, though. I think that you're going... This is what I think is going to happen. I think if you allow yourself to go out with a girl who's right there, allow yourself to get close. Because I asked you something, and I asked you to be honest, and you said that you were honest. When I asked you this question, I asked you, does your charge hurt you in dating? Like, does your charge hurt you when it comes to finding someone? Because I wanted to know, because you said no. Was that the truth?
It bothers me.
The charge?
Charge bothers a lot.
I know it bothers you, but does it hurt you when you're trying to date?
It affects me.
Like, because you have to explain it, or it affects you, like, how?
Because how I feel when I have to explain it.
But, like, when you explain it, do people say, oh, you know, we've all had our, you know, everyone has something in their past? Or do people...
Because I care about what people think about me.
Like, but when you... Well, no. But when you explain it, do people understand?
Most people do understand.
Good.
But it's still hard for me. That I made a mistake, and I don't know what the hell it is about me, but it seems to like me.
Well, there's a couple things I want to say to that, but I mean, I think that it's good, you know, that it doesn't affect you, and so therefore, that being the case, I think what's going to happen is once you start dating people and once you start going out and really experiencing that life, you're going to look back and you're going to say, she's right. And you might even run to the bathroom and text me and say, you were right. You literally might do that.
All the while, I spent more time with you, and we still stay just as close as ever.
But think about this.
And our feelings for each other don't go away.
No. Listen, think about this now. Think about how nice it'll be to be able to go to dinner with someone and know that, like, let's say Wednesday, and know that you guys are going to spend the day together on Saturday. Think about how nice that'll be.
You know, you think about this. How does it feel being with Corey when you're thinking about me?
I want you to go on dates, and I don't want you to.
I answer your questions. You don't answer mine. Keep going around them.
Because I'm trying to give you advice. You've said to me before that I've given you great advice.
Yeah, but I also want honesty from you.
Listen to me. You've never...
Going around
you've never had that. No, listen. You have never had that. And I'm not asking you intimate questions.
What?
How nice, think about how nice that will be for you. For you to be able to go to McDonald's or wherever the hell people in Maine go to eat. But no, for you to be able to go to dinner with the girl on Wednesday and know that you're going to see her and spend the day with her on Saturday. And to know that that she's so into you that you don't have to worry about whether or not she's seeing other people. You don't have to worry about whether or not she loves so-and-so. And think about what a step that's going to be.
If you tell me how it...
And you know what?
Go ahead.
And you know what? When you're seeing this person, if you get frustrated, if you get upset, message me, and I'll be there for you.
You tell me how it feels when you go out with Corey, when...
What does this have to do with me trying to help you get to a place where you can have a healthy relationship?
This has to do with what we've been through.
Lauren.
It has to do with the way we feel.
Lauren, but...
I want honesty from you. And I want answers. No, I don't want answers that you're going to go around them.
And I'm giving it to you, but you're rejecting it.
I'm not telling you out straight. I want it out straight. Are you in love with Corey?
I don't want to answer that because I want to help you because there's no answer.
Listen. I want honest, direct answer. Are you in love with Corey or not?
I'm trying to tell you I don't want to answer that. Because no matter what...
I don't want you to tell me...
Because we're getting off track.
Why you don't answer? I want a direct answer.
But here's the thing. When we talk about that, we're getting off track.
But no, we're not getting off track. I need to know.
Why does that matter? If I'm telling you...
I need to know.
Why? How does that affect anything that I'm saying?
Because it does.
How? In what way?
In every way.
In which way?
In every way. I'll tell you how after you tell me.
Boy. Lauren, I'm really trying here. You're making this difficult. I don't know if you're...
It's not difficult to tell me if you're in love with him or not.
It gets us off topic. And
no, it is not off topic.
Boy.
Are you in love with him?
There's no right answer to that question in this scenario.
The right answer is what is inside of you. That's what the right answer is. An honest answer.
There's no right answer because there's no right answer to that in this scenario.
Yes, there is. There's one answer. Either you are in love with him or you're not.
Either way, it's not going to affect what I'm saying to you, but I feel that it's going to affect your delivery or your receiving.
I want an honest answer.
Listen.
I want an honest, direct answer.
It's not going to affect what I'm saying to you.
Yes, it is.
But I feel like it's going to affect whether or not you choose to receive what I'm saying to you.
Give me an honest, direct answer.
I am.
You're in love with Corey.
I am giving you an honest, direct answer. I am telling you what I think. I am telling
you. Now, wait a minute. You said I am. Listen to me. Let me say this.
Okay.
You said I am. I said you are. So you are in love with Corey. You said no. I'm giving you a direct answer. And you just said no. You're not in love with Corey.
No, I said no. That's not what I meant when I said that. What I meant.
So you are. So you are in love with Corey.
Boy.
Just give me an answer. A yes or no answer. Are you in love with him?
It is not pertinent to what
Yes, it is. After 9 months, I deserve to know this shit. Are you in love with him?
I'm really trying here. I'm really trying here.
Well, you can try harder by telling me an honest, direct answer. I don't know how I can say that any different. There's no way to get more direct about how I'm asking that question.
How about I go middle of the road and I say, I don't know.
You don't know if you're in love with him or not?
How about I go middle of the road? I'm just going to go middle of the road.
No, is that an honest answer?
It's the one that I'm going to give.
Is it an honest one?
It's the one that I'm going to give.
Is it an honest one?
I feel like I'm talking to a wall.
Well, I get an honest answer. You are.
But who does that really benefit, though? Because that doesn't benefit you, and that's what I'm trying to do. That does not benefit you.
You want to benefit me? Tell me the truth.
When you have someone here.
You want to benefit me? Tell me the truth.
You have someone here who.
Elizabeth, you're going around the question again.
Okay, I just want you to hear this, okay? Because you need to hear this. You have someone here who has no, monetary gain to talk to you or anything like that. Who could literally just block your number and go on with her life. But instead, she's trying to talk to you and she's trying to help you. And she's sending her Sunday here trying to help you.
You want to help me?
No, but that's not the way to help you. The way to help you.
I deserve the truth.
I I am giving you the truth.
Tell me, are you in love with Corey or not?
Oh gosh, it's going nowhere.
Don't go around the question. Give me a straight, honest, truthful, direct answer. Yes or no?
I'm trying.
Yes,
there's no right answer. And
there's a right answer to tell me.
If I say no, then you're going to try to convince me of all of the reasons why I should wait for you. And if I say yes...
You already know why... If you say no, you already know why you should do it.
But here's the thing.
Because you haven't even met me yet, and part of you already loves me.
Oh, gosh. Okay, but here's the thing.
If you say, yeah, then it's going to be easier for me to let go.
But that's what I need you to do, and that's what you need to do. That's what's best for you. That's what's absolute best for you.
But when I let go, it's going to be completely. And that's what you don't want.
I want you to get to a point. Like I said, I don't want you to feel like you've wasted any time. I don't mind being your friend. I'd like that. I want you to get to a point where you can be happy with just being that, with just being friends and just being friendly. That's what I want for you.
Just be honest with me and tell me the truth.
I want you to...
Yes or no? Are you in love with Corey?
Lorne, I want you to let go. That's what I want.
Tell me the truth. Are you in love with him?
I want you to let go. I want you to let go.
I want you to tell me the truth. Yes or no? Are you in love with him?
I want you.
I'm going to go around it again.
Please don't, because we don't need to discuss that. I just want
you. Yeah, we do. Please tell me the honest truth. The direct answer, yes or no. Are you in love with him?
Whether or not I love anyone, I'm not making any changes in my life anytime soon.
Cut out. What did you just say?
I said, whether or not I love anyone, I'm not making any changes in my life anytime soon. So it's inconsequential.
Yes or no answer.
It's like I go from like wanting to help you to like wanting to hang up. I mean, you're not making this easy. You really aren't. And I'm really trying.
Did you really expect it to be easy after 9 months of not telling you the truth?
It's not that I expected it to be easy. It's that I hoped that you would be rational.
I'm being very rational. I'm being extremely rational.
Not at all. Listen to me.
I want to know the truth. I deserve to know the truth.
And I'm giving it to you.
Not when you don't answer my question.
I'm giving you the truth. You're not being rational because you're trying to find pieces of hope on why you...
No. I'm trying to find reason.
No, but you're trying to find pieces of hope and why you should wait and spend your life waiting for someone who lives...
I'm not waiting for anybody that doesn't want to meet me face to face. I've done that already.
And that's what I'm saying. You should be with someone
there. I want an answer. I want a direct answer. An honest, direct answer. I deserve to know the answer. After 9 months, I deserve to know. Are you in love with him?
Let me ask you something, okay? Do you have, because you told me that you did, do you have other girls who are right there, April or something? And Jennifer, Jessica,
April, I'm not all interested in April.
What about the girl at the...
Jen, I like Jen a little bit. I think she's cute, but I never talked to her that much.
Okay, so you do have prospects. What's wrong with April, then? Why aren't you too interested in her?
She's not... happy, if a person, though. Pretty, but...
She might be, honest.
She doesn't like... seem like she likes to laugh a whole lot.
She might be shy.
Pretty, but...
You could probably break her out of that.
Not all that interest in April. More attracted to Jen. But
that's awesome. Does she laugh at your jokes?
We don't talk that much. I didn't hardly ever see her now. I don't even know if she's working there now. I haven't seen her last 3-4 times I went there.
I don't see why she would have stopped. She probably still walks there.
But that's getting away from my question.
And maybe she hides because maybe you make her blush. Did you ever think of that?
I think of all kinds of things. But that's still getting away from my question. I'm not gonna ease up on my question.
I know you're not, but you know what? I am gonna help you with this. And
you want to help me, then answer my question.
I think that I would.
Are you in love with Tori?
The problem is that I don't think that you're going to realize I'm right until you actually go out and you get real world experience. That's the problem.
Problem is what?
I said the problem is that I don't think you're going to think that I'm right until you actually go out and get real world experience. That's what I think the issue is.
are you in love with Glory?
And so, I think that it would be a shame if you didn't take the advice that I'm trying to give you and the help that I'm trying to give you because you were fixated on getting an answer to a question.
I'm fixated on that because I deserve the answer to the question. After 9 months, I deserve all this shit. After the hell I've been through in the last couple of months, I very much deserve to know.
Well, let's be real. People in Texas who were dealing with Hurricane Harvey, they've been through hell. I said people in Texas who are dealing with Hurricane Harvey, they've been through hell. that's what hell is.
What do you consider what I've been through? Heaven?
Even then, going through what you consider a traumatic experience still does not entitle you to know everything that you've ever wanted to know or to have every answer that you ask or every question that you ask answered.
Don't turn it around so it seems like I don't deserve an answer out of that question. I do. No matter how you turn up. I deserve an answer to that question and many other questions that I have. Whatever questions I have. After 9 months, especially after the last 2 months of that, all that horseshit.
You're getting more than that.
I'm not getting more than that when you don't answer them.
Oh,
I need to know the reasons behind everything.
I'm giving you the reasons. I am giving you the reasons. The reason.
Okay, I want you to clear your mind of everything and think of me as a person on the street. And I ask you, are you in love with Corey?
No.
What are you going to tell me?
I'm going to say, I don't know you, and it's none of your damn business. I don't know who you are.
Pretend I'm one of your girlfriends. Are you in love with Corey?
If you're one of my girlfriends, you'd know the answer.
Well?
If you're one of my girlfriends.
Then tell me.
But see, that's the thing. You're not one of my girlfriends.
I'm the person that deserves the answer to that question.
But if one of my girlfriends was in love with me and trying to convince me to be with her, and she asked me that question, then...
I'm not going to try to convince you to be with me. If you don't want to be with me, that's not my business. That's not up to me. I can't force you to be with me. All I can do is be myself. You've already started loving who I am. I can't tell you what to do. But I do deserve an answer to the questions that I ask. If you were in my shoes, you would want an answer.
No, I'm not demanding to know if you're in love with April. I want you to be, or Jen.
Oh, I'm not in love with either one of them, so.
But I think it would be probably a good idea.
I deserve an answer to that question.
You know her last name? I might be able to look her up and find out. She still works at Walmart.
I don't know her last name. I don't know your last name either, still. You're afraid that I'll come down there and get you.
Well, when you say it like that.
You're the one who said that.
Well, when you say it like that, can you blame me?
Yeah, because I'm not coming down there to get you if I'm not invited. How would I do that for?
No, why would you do a lot of things? I don't know.
A lot of things, I don't know. I can ask that question too. Are you in love with him?
Oh,
I deserve the answer to that question.
No.
The only one that's making it hard is you.
It's irrelevant, because here's the thing. If somebody is telling you that you should be with someone else, does it matter who that person is with?
Tell me if I'm wrong.
About what particular?
This whole time that I have asked you that question, you have not told me.
I do think that it's that you're not entitled to know the answer.
How do you expect that?
I think that because it has nothing to do with you. Because here's the thing,
And I put some sense into that, because after 9 months, I'm the very first person that is entitled to an answer on that.
I'll give you a more extreme example, okay?
All I want it is a yes or no.
But I'm going to give you a more extreme example to kind of drive this point home, although I'm pretty sure it won't work, but I'm going to try. Because, hey, you know what? It's Sunday night, and I got nothing but time, apparently. Just been talking to you about this. So, let me use your mom and Dale as an example. When he broke up with her, and I don't agree with the way that he did it. I mean, he cheated on her, right? And that wasn't cool. I don't agree with that. But if she had asked him, are you in love with, I don't know the lady's name, but whoever the fuck it was that he left her for, she would not be entitled to know that. Why? Because he's telling her, I don't want to be with you. He's telling her, I'm leaving you. He's telling her these things, and A, they weren't married, but B, why is she entitled to know how he feels that she he's fucking? That's not her. You see what I mean?
Because you and I are not in that same situation.
No, we haven't been together for 27 years.
No. But are you telling me that you don't want me?
I am telling you that you can do better.
In other words, you're not telling me that you don't want me.
Lauren, I'm gently telling you that you can do better. And I think that it would be very healthy for you. I think that it would be very healthy for you to agree with that and to come to a place where you could see that. I think that would be very healthy.
You're not telling me that you don't want me. You're telling me you think I could do better than you.
I would think that for you, it would be healthy for you to arrive at the conclusion that you should be with such, that you should look for someone else without me having to say that. I think that that would be very healthy for you.
Well, what are you having to say what?
I forgot, but I think, but basically that it would be healthy for you to come to the idea that you can do better. And I think you can.
That I can do better than you.
That you can do better than what I'm offering you. You can do.
What are you offering me?
Or I'm sorry, you can do better than what I can offer you, I should say.
What can you offer me?
Not someone who's there for you the way that you want. And I think that it's going to take you getting out there to realize that. I think that that's what it's going to take. I think it's going to take you going out on dates and you meeting.
No, you're telling me that you're not in love with Corey.
Oh, gosh.
That's what you're telling me.
Say again?
That's what you're telling me. That you're not in love with Corey.
I didn't say anything about him.
Everything you said is the only conclusion is that you're not in love with Corey.
Okay, I'm going to allow you to come to that conclusion, but I'm also...
I want the truth, because I do deserve the truth.
Okay, I'm going to allow...
I think it's mean that you would hold back from me.
Listen, I think that you will be so happy when you have somebody who's there, and what I think that you're fighting is not whether or not you want to know something. I think that you're fighting this because it's...
I'm fighting for the truth, so it would be easier for me to go whatever way I'm going to go.
But regardless of how I feel, I'm telling you that that's what you need to do.
Why do you want me to continue to wonder?
I don't want you to wonder. I don't want you to think about it.
No. I'm going to think about it.
I don't want you to.
Because you're not telling me the truth, bullshit. I'm
telling you everything. I'm telling you.
Okay, then tell me out straight.
That
honest truth. Are you in love with Corey?
That is not.
Oh my God.
I am telling you that what you should be focused on.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how much do you love me?
Well, that's an odd one. I don't know how to answer that, because
that's the best way to do it. On a scale of 1 to 10. How much do you love me? And I want it honest. And I don't want to. I'm going to feel how I feel. You should give me an honest answer anyway, so that makes so that
you know what?
For yourself that you gave an honest answer.
This is the answer, because I can't think of a number, but I'm going to tell you that it's not what you deserve. I'm going to tell you that whatever I say, there's someone in Maine who will be even higher. Because I don't have a number. I don't have a number. But whatever...
And if we were face-to-face, how high do you think that number would be?
But here's the thing, though, is that we're not. And here's the thing. You could find someone who is. And that's scary to you because you've never had that before.
It's scary to you because I've never had it.
No, it's scary to you. Wait, no. It's scary to you because you've never had that before. It's really scary.
It has been scary to me. Right up until you, I was set to be face to face with you.
But I am just a band-aid, and anybody who you meet online is just a band-aid.
No, what I gave was not a band-aid.
No. But what?
I literally gave my all.
But what me and what anybody else who you've never met, who you say you love. All they represent is a band-aid. They represent a band-aid for the fact that you have not had a real face-to-face, long-term relationship, and you're scared and you're nervous about it, and so it's easy to keep people at arm's length. because it's easier to have someone at arm's length.
It's not easier to keep somebody at arm's length. What it needed to be was what we were, so that I could get to know them, so they could get to know me, then we can meet, then we go from there.
But here's the thing, though. If that's not the case, then why is it that you have existed for so long without ever having a real long-term face-to-face relationship? Why? If what I said is not...
Since the sting?
No, because
that's affected me.
And that's what I think is scaring you, because now you're going to have to go, and there's a chance you're going to have to explain that. And I think the best way for you to do that is to explain it the same exact way that you've explained it to me, and say exactly what you've said to me. That's the best way to explain that. That's the only way to explain that, is to say exactly what you've said to me about it. That's the only way that you're going to be able to explain that. And, well, I'll tell you the other thing that I think in a minute, but that's how you're going to explain it. There was this thing, you did something bad, you regret it. It's not who you are, it's who you seemed like, but that's not who you are. You made a mistake, and you've moved on with your life. That's it.
I want you to think about all the time that we spent together.
That what you said?
I want you to think about all the time that we spent together.
And that's why I'm on the phone with you, trying to talk you through this.
I want you to think how happy we both were when we were spending all that time together.
I am. That's why I'm on the phone with you, trying to talk you through this.
Trying to talk me through this so that you can let me go and feel good that you were trying to let me go, even though you don't want to let me go.
No. So that you can feel good knowing that you don't have to worry, so you know that you are with someone who's right there. That's why.
So, in other words, you're trying to take away my choice.
What choice?
My choice.
Well, yeah, I mean, choice about what? Choice in regards to what?
In regards to whatever I want with what I decide to do. Regardless of what anybody says, any choice that I make is mine. It's not anybody else.
Exactly. But I'm saying that
you're not in love with Corey, that you do love me. And you're trying to let me go so I can have somebody face-to-face. But you're going to stay with Corey because it's convenient, because you're used to him.
Well, isn't that the most... Well, you know what? If that's what you're taking out of that, then I think that would be the most loving thing anybody's ever done for you. Told you that they don't want you to wait for them and to sit around hoping that something happens and hoping for this and that, and that you go out and that you live your life and that you find someone that makes you happy, even if it's not them, so that you can be in a relationship and so that you can move on with your life and find happiness. I think that if that's the way that you want to phrase that, then that's the most selfless thing that I have ever heard of anybody doing.
That's the way I'm phrasing it. That's what I'm hearing. But what I really want is, I want to know, is that the truth or is it not the truth?
I
don't want a lying answer. And I don't want an answer that just to make it sound good, make it feel I want an honest answer.
The honest answer that is the answer that I've been giving you, which is that I think, or not that I think, I know that you will be happier once you take my advice. And you're very stubborn. You really are.
I am. I am. I know I am.
You're extremely stubborn, and it's funny.
That's because when I wanted to answer, I answer everybody's question when they want it, so I expect the same in return.
But here,
so why shouldn't I be stubborn?
You shouldn't be stubborn because I'm doing what I truly believe, and you said that I've helped you before psychologically. I'm doing what I truly believe is helpful and is going to help you in the long run. And this is based off of countless hours and hours and hours and hours I've spent on the phone with you talking you through stuff.
Hours and hours and hours that we spent on the phone just with each other, just having fun with each other.
And you know what? And if that's built, then that builds a friendship, and that's really nice. I think that's really nice.
It built more than a friendship. That's what it built. It built, on my end, it built more than a friendship. Obviously, part of you loves me, it built more than a friendship with you, too. Don't deny what's the actual
truth. But let that be what that is now. Because, hey, you know what? You want to talk about time spent with people? No, I spent 4 years with a guy, close to 4 years, and now, you know, I wouldn't even speak to him if I saw him in the grocery store. So I mean, there, I could say that that's 4 months wasted. I mean, 4 years wasted or what? But the fact of the matter is that,
Now you spend 5 years with a guy. Are you in love with him or not?
Oh, God, I shouldn't have said anything about people like that. You are very stubborn. You're very
well. I'm telling you that it kind of stands out that you're not in love with him, because you don't even sleep with him. You sleep on the couch all the time.
But
you spent the last 9 months with me.
But here's the thing. This is me. What I'm doing, regardless of how you take it that way. If that's the way you want to take it that way. But realize that.
But see, when you say that. When you say that, that's what bothers me. When you say that, if that's the way you want to take it that way. When you say it's like you want me to think that way, but that might not actually be the truth. I want the truth.
But I'm trying to give it to you. It's just not the truth.
Well, then you need to give it to me straight instead of going around that.
I am telling you that you have women in your area who are interested in you. I am telling you that, well, for one thing, your state is bigger than mine. I think the population, I don't know what the population is, but there are a bunch of women there who would love to get to know you. And I think that that's where your mind should be. Because listen to me. You are, and I'm not saying your age is an insult. I'm not saying it to make you feel old or anything.
Well, you're 29. You're not 24 anymore, so you're not insulting me.
You're 47. Do you want to spend your time chasing after someone, or do you want someone who walks with you? Do you want to have to chase someone, or do you want someone who walks with you?
I want someone that I love and that loves me. That's what I care about.
And you can find that in your state.
Yeah, I found it already, and it's not in my state. Mm-hmm. All I want is the truth. But either way, it's going to be easier for me to move forward, knowing what the truth actually is.
Lorne, I'm telling you, I want you, it's time for you to move forward. And I've even offered to help you.
Listen. First step to helping me is being honest with me.
And I am.
And you need to tell me the truth about everything. And direct answers. Rumble answers. That's the first step in helping me.
I feel like if that has to be it, then there's already a problem. Because here's the thing. Because it tells me that you're not listening to what I'm saying. Because what I'm saying to you is that you need to get to a place where you can be other people and be fine with it and be happy with it and move on. Now, if
there is no, you said that if you truthful with me, there's already a problem. There's not already a problem.
Here's the thing, because if I say yes, I am, you feel like you wasted 9 months. If I say no, I'm not, you still feel like there's a chance. That's the problem.
But what the problem is not knowing.
But you don't
know how you feel about it either way.
But here's the thing.
That's the first step to me being able to move forward so that I know that I can deal with it. Listen to me. Either way, I will continue to talk to you. But you have got to guarantee me that you will never have anything to do with Emma again. Oh, that church is called bullshit.
I have told you that nothing else that we have discussed is going to end up on mine.
You have no idea how vital that is.
I agree.
The feds are watching her. Literally.
What do you mean?
I mean, the feds are literally watching her.
Like watching, like how? Like, I mean, I don't know what you mean.
The internet is worldwide. It doesn't take much for them to watch her.
They're watching her for what? Like, I just don't understand, like, why, I guess.
For anything and everything that she is doing.
How do you know this?
Probably because my probation officer is a federal probation officer.
What's the difference between that and the regular one?
A state probation officer can't go all over the United States. A federal probation officer can. He has connections to the whole United States. All you have to do is look up a number and dial it. This crap with the shit that Emma's doing. Has done. She's done some illegal shit. Well, I tried to get you away from her. That's why it floored me when you started having anything to do with her.
Well, why did I say
that? You thought I was best friends with Emma still? I was a talk of shit. You knew how much I didn't like her.
We'll get to a point where, I guess, get to a point where she just doesn't put any more stuff out there on the internet or anything like that. But, I mean, like I said.
This is why I'm telling you, you cannot have anything to do with her. I talk to you. You cannot have anything to do with her. You got to guarantee me that. Two lengths that you've never gone to.
What are you worrying about?
I'm worrying about you getting in trouble.
In what way? For what? I didn't do anything.
By having anything to do with Emma.
Why would I get in trouble?
If you're in connection with Emma. She's already talked to him and doing stupid shit. Why are you so hesitant now?
Because I'm like, no, I mean, I'm like confused. What would I get in trouble for?
Anything that she's doing. Record shit and give it to her. Put online. About me. Or about anybody.
Well, like I said.
She's already brought one guy to commit suicide.
Who committed?
The guy was a piece of shit, but he probably deserved not be on the earth.
Who committed suicide?
Somebody that I know about. Somebody that I know about. Have you been talking to him in the last days?
No, I'm just trying to figure out who committed. Like, was it one of the members of your group, your church group?
No.
Well, like I said.
Have you had anything to do with them in the last few days?
No, but like I said, hopefully she doesn't put anything else about us on the internet. I don't see why she would. But like I said, don't worry about any of that stuff.
I worry about it because that whatever it was, it live. The live thing. How's it called? And you and I were on the phone.
Ow.
That was all being heard live. That wasn't such a good idea. That was about one of the worst ideas she's ever had.
By the way, who was telling you about that stuff? I'm curious. Who was telling you about that?
What do you think?
Your probation officer?
There you go.
What, they were texting you?
Huh?
I said, what, they were texting you?
Yep.
Hmm?
Yep.
Say again?
They're not stupid. They're not stupid. They're far from stupid.
Well, like I've said,
So, if you had any thought of having to do with anything to do with Emma again, you might want to bury that thought.
You threatening me?
Huh?
I said, are you threatening me?
What?
I said, are you threatening me?
Am I threatening you?
Yeah, why are you saying it like that?
You might want to bury the thought so you don't get your ass in trouble.
I'm not getting in trouble. I didn't do anything.
I don't know how much you think it's a good idea to have anything to do with her, but it's not a good idea. I'm trying to tell you that all straight. I'm trying to let you know that is not the best person to be friends with.
She's gonna do to me.
Get you in trouble.
So I do, like, what? I mean, typically, I would
like
have
like a phone call, you know, the internet live. That shit's illegal. Trying to protect you.
Like I said, I'm not doing anything, and, you know, our conversations are not going to end up online.
Oh, no, I hope you're not doing having anything to do with it. That's why I completely stopped.
Like I said, don't worry.
I kind of worry when you get so hesitant like you just did.
Well, no, I just wanted to know why you were saying, like, you know, I just wanted to know why you were saying it the way that you were saying it. Like, that's all.
Because the feds aren't stupid and they're trying to protect you.
But, you know.
Are you texting her right now?
No. I'm sitting here talking to you and making a necklace at the same time. But, like, I think that that you personally shouldn't worry about this stuff. Because, I mean, I already told you, I'm not releasing anything to go online. You don't have to worry about that. And, I mean, I'm obviously not an asshole because I have pictures of you that everybody was begging to see, and I'm not releasing them, so.
You know, she's lost her channel more than one time.
Lost it a million times. But that's not saying much, because YouTube is quick to take down people's channels.
My channel was never taken down.
You're a unique case.
Use it for what it's actually there for.
Like a unique nutcase.
Huh?
I said you're a unique case, and then I said more like a unique nutcase. But,
how am I a nutcase?
Just take my word on that. No, but
take your word on I'm a nutcase. Alrighty then.
I'm mostly joking. No, but like I said,
you said I was a nutcase.
I said I need a sip of water. That's what I said now. Yeah, your channel is something else. I don't know what, but I know that people will be drawn to your channel for, some people will be brought there by the song, some people will see, you know, the dogs, and some people will see the vegan recipes and stuff, and, oh, if they need a story behind the channel, as I've said before.
Yeah. I don't understand why this still getting subscribers. I haven't been on there for over 3 months. How many people have subscribed to it now?
Are you asking me to check?
Yeah.
Hang on, but I'm not going to check YouTube, please.
Last I knew, it was like 909. That was like 2 days ago.
Hang on. Let's see how many people are on. Ow! Is it Lorne Armstrong or Lorne Armstrong? I'm kidding. 909.
909?
Yeah, 909.
That doesn't make any sense. When I get off of there, there's just over 700. It's like almost 200 people have subscribed to my channel in a little over 3 months. I'm not even there.
Wait, how many people in 3 months?
Almost 200. Damn close to it. That'd be damn close. I think last I remember it was like 726 or something like that.
Maybe people think that you're people probably think you're coming back. Yeah, people probably think you're coming back.
That shit doesn't make any sense at all.
You seem disappointed by it.
I kind of am, because I just want people on the internet, though.
See what you said?
I kind of just want people on the internet to forget about me.
To forget about you?
Yes. I got that whole church of crap gone. It's unbelievable.
Hold on, because you're cutting out.
I said that church of cod crap shit was so stupid. People that just don't have a life have they find to do.
They make
their own entertainment.
Well, like I said, you know, don't worry about them. Don't worry about that. The way that you explained it away in the letter was perfect.
Where they explained it in the letter. What letter?
The letter that you sent me. That you wrote to Kathleen or Katrina.
Katrina, you mean though?
For your job. You just explain it like that. And you know, just
doesn't take away the bag, but it still needs no. Wanna help me take the first part and help.
I well back to this.
Yeah, well, you didn't really think he was gonna leave, did you?
I don't know what I thought. Maybe I wasn't thinking. I don't know.
Really need the truth. I need the honest truth about everything. Whether you think it's going to hurt me or help me is irrelevant. Because you're not me, so you don't know exactly what thoughts are going through my head.
Half the time, I don't think you know the thoughts that are going through your head.
Oh, I don't until they pop up there.
Oh, no, you don't until you've acted on them.
Uh-huh.
I said you don't until you've acted on them.
Well, that's the analyst.
Just stop overthinking things.
No, I'm not. I'm not overthinking. It's a matter of that I need to know so I can process things better. So if something down the road doesn't pop up, I say, well, fuck, I fucking thought that one wrong and feel like an idiot.
A second, because I'm switching from Bluetooth to headphones because my Bluetooth is dying. Hello?
Hello, how are you?
Okay, hang on, let me turn this off. Alright. I'm going to charge that. I can say that. Well, it's a pretty long time, that thing. That's a decent debt. Okay, what were you saying?
I'm saying, are you in love with him or not?
Oh, back to this.
He never really left us. We just paused for a minute.
Yeah, but in that time, I forgot some of what I was saying.
Okay, well, kind of straight on my question.
No.
Just give me the honest truth. That's the first step in helping you.
I think that the honest truth is I think that you will be best off if you take my advice.
Oh, come on.
Yes.
You're trying to go around it again.
No, I'm just being honest. I think that you will be the best off if you take my advice. And you...
Yes, but we've already ran into a problem.
What?
That you think.
No, but you will.
What you think.
Okay, then...
You don't know. Cause you have to let me decide on...
Okay, then... I challenge you to ask your therapist. Ask her.
Challenge you to give me an honest, truthful answer. Are you in love with it?
No, I challenge you to ask your therapist if she thinks what I'm saying is right.
Can you please stop going around?
I'm not.
You are. Please give me a direct, honest, truthful answer.
I'm going to go middle of the room. I'm going to say I don't know.
No. No, I don't want the middle of the road. I want an honest answer. It is not hard to tell me a truthful, honest answer. Hey, you're making it a lot harder than what it is.
That's what she said.
That's what she who, Ramona?
Oh boy, you've never heard of that's what she said joke?
Yes, I have.
Okay. Good grief.
I was trying to be smart ass.
No, but I was going to say, I was like, what?
But you didn't get it because your name is Elizabeth. I said that's what. She who? Ramona? That's what Ramona said? Get it?
I know, but I didn't...
You're Ramona and you're Elizabeth.
I know that, but I'm...
Do you get it now?
No, I know that, but I'm just... It just, the way that you had said it sounded like you didn't understand what I meant. Who's she?
Like I said, I'm smarter than what you seem to think.
Oh, boy. You seem to think everybody thinks you're dumb.
Yep.
You say that joyfully. Like, yep, everybody thinks I'm dumb.
I do. I don't tell everybody everything that I know.
What do you know that you don't tell people?
I know a lot that I don't tell people.
In regards to what?
In regards to anything and everything.
Do you like to be mysterious?
No, I like to make other people think that they're smarter than what they are.
Do what?
I like to make other people think they're smarter than what they are.
That you want total honesty from people, but you don't.
A lot of times it's just I'm trying not to be rude to them and butt into them and tell them, you don't need to tell me this because I already know. A lot of it's just trying not to be rude.
This is interesting.
Well, that's the way I was raised. Might not be the right way, but it's the way I was raised. But I do know what's best for me, as far as knowing whether or not you're on mobile. That's why I keep harping on it.
But I just,
getting a direct answer.
I think that your therapist would agree that it's not about that, and it's more about what she's saying to you, and B, you getting to a place where you can have a healthy relationship. I think that your therapist would agree with me.
I don't know whether yes or no.
Like I said, I think that your therapist would agree with me. In fact, I don't think I know she would.
Yeah, okay, answer me this question. Do you like it when I call you B?
Say again?
Do you like it when I call you B?
You can call me whatever you want.
What fellow would you like it?
You can call me Mom, you can call me Dad,
Don't try to distort.
You can call me Grandma.
Go to the store. Go to the store at all.
You can call me Grandma. In fact, I prefer Grandma.
You're a little younger to call Grandma.
Yeah, but there have been grandmas my age, believe it or not.
Oh, I believe it. And I know what.
I was about to tell you an interesting fact. Do you know how old the youngest person to ever have a baby was?
11.
Huh?
11.
Nope.
How young?
5.
What?
5 years old. And I will leave it.
Are you fucking serious?
I kid you not. Her name was Lena something. And
wow.
I was 5 years old, and I saw a picture of her pregnant. I'll leave it to your imagination as to how she got pregnant.
I don't want to know.
I wasn't going to tell you. I'll just say this, that the father of the baby was an adult.
Fuck.
She might still be alive. Her child, if healthy, should definitely be alive. She might still be alive.
Hold your life up forever.
Say again?
That little girl's life fucked up forever.
Yeah. Unbelievable.
Terrible. Kind of wish you hadn't seen it that.
Oh. Youngest grandma. How old do you think?
I'm gonna guess I'm not even going to guess.
Take a guess. Take a guess.
I say...
Youngest ever grandmother.
I guess 25.
17.
All right, on to a better subject.
All right.
Let's get away from that shit.
Crazy, isn't that, man?
Okay. That's awesome. All right. On to a better subject.
All right.
Are you in love with him or not?
Oh, gosh, how's that a better subject?
That's a lot better subject. Any subject is better than that one that we're at.
I thought it was going to be about, like, ice cream, vegan ice cream.
Huh?
I thought it was going to be, like, about vegan ice cream or something.
About DNA?
Vegan ice cream.
Oh. We'll talk about that later. It's a private answer out of you. Please give me a direct answer. Honest. Yes. Elizabeth.
Are you hitting any Labor Day sales tomorrow?
Elizabeth. Please give me an honest answer, Elizabeth. I don't know why you don't want to answer my question.
I said a bunch of things about it already.
Said a bunch of things about it already, yes. But it all pointed away to no, you're not.
Boy.
That's why I want an honest, direct answer of yes or no.
Your action cannot be contingent to any question like that. That's why I haven't answered it.
My actions are not going to be contingent on your answer.
But you're
still going to be the same me.
But your thoughts shouldn't either.
I don't know what my thoughts are going to be. But I know what my actions have to do.
And, you know, my feelings for other people are not your business. And, you know.
This one here is.
It is. Mm-mm.
It is, and you know what it is.
You're not entitled to it just because you're demanding it, though.
I am entitled to what?
No. That's where you're wrong.
And also, if you want help me, you've got to tell me.
But I'm trying to, and I'm also trying to do it.
Answer. All I need is a direct answer of yes or no. Going around it.
Because I don't...
Make it harder going around it.
I don't see either of them being a beneficial answer.
But you need to let me be the judge of that. I'm the one that has to process it.
But I'm telling you.
Will you just tell me yes or no?
I'm telling you what I think.
I know you told me what you think.
And
I'm
you,
trying to tell you what I'm trying to tell you what I know.
You seem to only want my advice when it's stuff that you like.
No, I've taken your advice a lot.
And how's that worked out for you?
I'll answer that when you answer my question.
No, because I know that my advice is good. My advice is great.
Because it feels to not get an answer from me.
My advice, my advice is solid.
How's it feel to not get an answer?
Well, no, because I know the I know the answer to the answer. My advice is solid.
Your advice is good.
I know it's good. It's not good. It's great. My advice works.
I gave you the answer to your question. Now you can answer my question.
No, it's not. It's
you,
not
like you see how I. You see how I made it easy for you. No, what I thought, or what was going on inside of me, about you.
This is not let's make a deal.
No, it's not let's make a deal. It's pretty simple. I know what's going on inside of me. I know what I think. I know how I think.
I don't even know if that can be known. That's an unsolved mystery.
Well, when you're real with me, it's not so unsolved.
No, the way the wheels turn there, I don't know if that can be known.
When the person is real with me, it's not so unknown. When the fucked up shit happens. No different than anybody else. Just go about thought process a different way. I'm no different than I said I'm no different than anybody else. My thought process is in a different way.
Oh, you're gonna use the word different. That's euphoric. Or euphemism. No, I'm just teasing, but no, like I said, my advice still stands, regardless of anything else, regardless of the answer to that question. My advice still stands. My advice is good, and what I said is the truth.
Okay, but you want to help me? First step to helping me is telling me the truth, the honest truth about.
And I've answered why I don't want to answer that.
Well, you've answered why you don't want to answer it, but that's you thinking that you know what's going to happen, and you don't. You taking away my choice of how I can make a decision on how I'm going to do things.
Because I'm telling you that the answer to that question should not have that your next step should not have any contingency on the answer to that question. None whatsoever.
It's not going to.
Then why are you saying?
Because I still need to know the truth.
You just implied that it would with what you just said.
Yeah, because it all has to do with my thought process. How I'm going to process everything about it. I need to be able to process this stuff. You can't just skip steps and being held.
What do you mean?
I can't jump from square one to square ten without starting at square one.
Wait, why are we standing on squares?
Little steps. we'd be so much further already if you'd just answer my question, yes or no. Answer it honestly.
And what's that going to do?
Answer it honestly, and you'll see. Answer it honestly, and we'll both see.
Wait, so this is like a trial, is like a scratch and sniff type thing?
Like a what?
A scratch and sniff.
Yeah, kind of. Are you in love with Elizabeth? Elizabeth? Hello?
Yes, sorry.
Are you in love with him?
Hang on.
Okay. Elizabeth.
Yes. Do you know any songs by Prince?
Huh?
I said, do you know any songs by Prince? Yes, my question.
I don't know them all the way by heart, no. I don't know, do no songs.
Let me guess, you know Raspberry Beret and Purple Heart. Or Purple Heart, what am I talking about? Raspberry Beret and Purple Rain.
Yeah, but I don't know him by heart. Are you in love with him?
And you might know, oh, Party Like It's 1999. And When Doves Cry. Oh, man, he had a lot of great songs.
Are you in love with him?
This is what it sounds like when doves get high. Is it when doves get high or when doves cry? No, I'm kidding. It's when doves cry. Doves should not be getting high.
No, we should not. Maybe I should be low.
Say, oh, gosh.
Please give me an honest, direct answer of yes or no. Are you in love with her? Elizabeth.
What?
You're ignoring me.
I am not.
You're avoiding me.
Maybe.
No, maybe you called it. You're not answering my question. You're avoiding me. Answer my question, please. Are you in love with him? Elizabeth.
What?
Elizabeth.
Yep.
Are you in love with him? Elizabeth.
Yeah.
Are you listening to me?
In general, technically speaking.
Are you in love with him?
Hang on.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
I was waiting for you. You told me hang on.
And I'm back.
But you never told me.
I said hang on. And as you had said, what are you doing? I was coming back.
Oh.
Oh my gosh, they're doing the... They're profiling the murder, Richard Krasinski.
They're doing a got a what?
This is a crime show.
Can you answer me, please?
Oh, God.
I'm not going to get off it, because I want to know. I've got to know. That's got to be step one.
And what does it do?
Huh?
And what does it do for you?
Makes me be a process thing.
The way that you process things, I feel like it could be unhelpful.
What was it? It's not unhelpful. I've got to be able to process it. And it would be unhelpful if I couldn't process
it. No, but... What is there to process in this?
Because that's the first step to processing anything.
Huh?
That's the first step to processing anything. It's one of the biggest things.
What is?
It's the first step. Processing anything is knowing the biggest thing. Somebody dies, we don't go to a family member and say, somebody down the road, or your son down was walking in the middle of the road and he might or might not have gotten hit. Process that. We'll be back in a few hours. And we'll tell you that he's really dead. See what I'm saying?
That's,
kind of cut and dry.
No, that's a bad answer. And I feel like you're trying to emotionally manipulate me into giving you an answer.
No, I'm not.
That's exactly
I'm trying to tell you. You asked me how it works. I'm trying to tell you. It's easier to process the biggest things first.
But those aren't the biggest things.
That is one of the biggest things. It's probably the biggest thing. It's something you need to tell me so I know one way or the other.
What does it matter? This is not about me. This is about you.
This is about me and you.
I know, but...
in the last 9 months.
This is about you.
This is about honest.
And I'm being as honest as I can. And I am telling you.
And be honest with me.
Are
you in love with him or not?
Listen. I am telling you.
You're making it harder than what it is.
I'm telling you, it would behoove you. If I just flat out tell you that I'm not going to answer that question, and I'm not going to give you an answer, what are you going to say?
I don't know. You haven't told me yet. I don't know what I'm going to say.
No. I mean, if I tell you that I'm not going to answer that question.
I'll be able to process it.
You should be processing it.
How should I be processing it?
This is what you should be processing. And I'm going to tell you, this is what you should be thinking. You should be thinking, how can I move forward in my life and see someone else and date someone else and make relationships face-to-face with a woman? How can I do that? That should be where your thought process is right now. That should be it.
How can I do that when I don't know?
Because the answer to that
the whole honest truth about the woman that I just spent 9 months with.
Because the answer to that question that you're asking me has nothing to do, nor
does it have everything to do with us.
But it doesn't change what I'm saying to you right now. It doesn't change it.
It doesn't change it. It might not change that. But it helps me to be able to process that.
You should be able to process this because I'm trying to help you to process this by telling you.
But you're not helping me when you don't tell me, isn't it? When you're not completely honest with me about everything.
What you're doing right now is something that I hate. And what it is it's people asking for closure, okay? Let me give you an example, okay?
Don't you think that would be a first step in anything?
No, because I don't like that word. It shouldn't even exist in the English language. It shouldn't exist.
I don't look for closure. I look for acceptance.
Here's why closure and the other thing that you just said should not exist. Because if one person, right? So let's say that Let's say that someone's dating whoever, I don't know, just whoever. And one person decides this relationship isn't for me, I'm out. The other person has, you know, yeah, if that person wants to sit down and say, well, you know, I ended it with you because I don't like the fact that you don't want to have sex 10 times a week or whatever. If they want to sit down and talk about all that emotional bullshit, that's on them. But they're under no obligation to do that. That's their life. You're not married to that person. They're under no obligation to tell you what you want to hear or to give you any kind of closure to make you feel better about the fact that they don't want to be with you. They're under no obligation to do that. Now, what I'm doing...
Be honest, you mean?
Now, what... The person, in the example I'm giving, the person was honest. They fucking said they didn't want to be with you.
You don't want to be with
me. Oh, God, Lauren, I'm giving you an example. Listen to me.
You mean you did, so you do want to be with me.
Oh, God.
Oh, God. I can't help but do that to you.
But it's not funny, because...
It's funny because I had to laugh about that one. I found humor in it.
Okay, I'm not going to talk about how I feel about anybody. I'm just going to talk about what I was saying.
After the last 9 months, you should be able to be honest with me about that. Regardless of how you think I might feel, it might not. To be honest with me about it, because you know I deserve to know. Because of all that I did not know before.
I don't know where you get this entitlement that you deserve to know everything that you ask just because you asked.
Because when I asked before, I wasn't told the truth.
When you asked when?
9 months ago.
Lauren, you went from, we were, quote, best friends, to all of a sudden you were telling me that you wanted to get married. I mean, that's not how you do things.
I know. I was fucked up at the time. What do you want me to say? I was worried that I was going to lose you to some fucking doctor that didn't even exist.
But that's how you've done things in all of your dealings with people. And that's not how you do things. That's just not how you do it, Lauren.
No, it's not how you do things. But also, how you don't do things is you don't make up people that don't exist. Isn't it just to make somebody else feel threatened by them?
Go through
that. How you do things either.
Okay, listen, we could go through that, or we could discuss the fact that I'm trying to help you.
Then, want to help me, just tell me, are you in love with him or not? You're making more out of it than what it's going to be.
All right, let's run with this. Yes, madly.
What?
I said, then let's try it. Then let's go with this one. Yes, madly. Oh my gosh, so much so.
See, that sounded heartfelt.
So much so.
Now, is that honest?
Yes, so much so. I'm not even trying to say it in any kind of dialect. I'm just saying it. So much so.
Yes, you are in love with him, so much so.
So much so. Oh, my God. So much so. And I want you to find... Are you laughing?
No, I just flushed the toilet. Just took a piss.
Okay, well...
Huh?
No. Okay. Anyway. And you can have the scene. So much so.
What? Oh, yeah.
With someone else. So much so.
Are you madly in love with him? So much so.
Now, how do you feel?
Right now, I'm trying to decide whether or not you're being honest. It doesn't sound like you're being honest.
I'm intentionally not trying, I'm intentionally, I don't know how to word it. I am intentionally not saying it with any particular inflection.
Well, I kind of figured that with the way you said it. I don't have any thought process right now because I don't know if it's being honest or not. I asked you to be honest.
And
the way you said it, didn't sound like it was very heartfelt.
So much so. Kind of inflection.
Okay. So you're madly in love with him so much so.
Are you now going to analyze it?
Yeah, because I have to wonder. You know, madly in love with him so much so that you. That would love me too.
Oh, good God. Oh,
I don't know. It's not a surprise to you that I analyze stuff. I told you all straight that I do.
But analyzing things and overthinking things in ways that are not beneficial to anyone, especially yourself, are two different things. And like I said, no matter what I say, you're going to pick what you want out of it.
I'm going to analyze.
Okay, and so you analyze that, and what does it come? What does it lead you to?
Leads me to be able to think. Or are you? Were you being honest with me? Hello.
I'm here. Go ahead. What were you gonna say?
Are you being honest with me?
Yes. Lord.
Okay, so now you can answer some questions for me.
Wait, what?
Now you can answer questions for me.
Okay, so there's more questioning. Okay, go ahead. Okay, so let's start the interrogation process.
Madly in love with him. Why would you allow me to continue thinking that you didn't have a boyfriend?
I felt bad for you, Lorne. I really did. I mean, you...
9 months?
Yes, I felt really bad for you. It puts someone in a weird position.
It puts you in a weird position.
It does, because it's like this guy likes you and this is all he has going for him. And he really doesn't have anybody else, and so...
It's a 9 months that he could have been going out looking for somebody else that was real.
But I kept telling you at different times, and you can't say that I didn't because But you know I did, though. Several times I told you. I did. I truly did. And you know I did. We both know that I did.
How could you do me so long?
Because I felt bad. I was not expecting that someone who I was talking to over the phone would all of a sudden one day decide that they were in love with me and wanted to marry me. And I did not know how to react to that.
Are you touched on it? No. And let Emma
how
do her shit.
It? How
let Emma
you...
do allowed Emma to do that shit for the last 2 months.
Look, how do you handle someone who does that? I mean, that puts someone in a really weird position, and that's what I'm telling you. I was not somebody who just, took everything that you said back to the group, because I didn't do that. And laughed at everything that you said. I didn't do that either.
Oh, you're acting like a real girlfriend.
I mean... This is so weird. This is really bizarre. They could literally make a movie out of this. The only thing is, this is, really bizarre.
This makes no sense. None at all.
No, it doesn't, Lauren. The fact that I called you... Well, actually, texted you, tried to text you, and you insisted that I called you. So, that's what you did. I tried to call you, or text you, you insisted that I called you.
I don't like texting. I don't like texting.
And I was trying to be a friend. And that's what I did. That's what I wanted to do. And that's what I still am going to do.
When I asked you to be my girlfriend, you said yes.
You didn't ask me.
I did ask you.
You
asked me. Okay.
You didn't ask me. You had implied it in an assuming way. But look, I'm not going to.
In 9 months, you let me believe it.
Lauren, it's not that so much for 9 months that I let you believe it. It's for 9 months you ran with it, and I didn't do anything to stop it. That's what happened. Literally, for 9 months, you ran with it, and I didn't stop it.
You didn't stop it, that's right.
But you know what, though? If I was heartless, I could have easily just blocked you when instead of telling you the truth, I could have just blocked you and been done with it.
So how do you feel about me compared to him?
I mean, I did my best to be there for you.
How do you feel about me compared to him?
I answered your main question, and now you're gonna have a lot of more questions. And I'm telling you,
the questions that never even should have came up to begin with.
Boy, this all they
did.
Boy, this
all on last night.
This whole thing should have never happened. It should have just been two people.
No, it shouldn't have.
It should have just been two people who were just friends who just talked. a couple times a week, and that was just that. That's what this should have been.
That's what it should have been, but we're not on the should have been. We're on what actually did happen.
Okay, and now I'm telling you what needs to happen.
How do you feel about me compared to him? Madly in love with him. How much so? How do you feel about me compared to him?
Lord, I care about you enough to tell you the truth and to tell you that I think that you deserve better, and better is out there.
And I need you to be truthful about this, too.
I am.
Are you madly in love with me so much so, too, or are you...
Lord, I... I'm going to answer it like this, and the way that I answer it, I want you to learn something from it, okay? I'm really trying to help you, Lauren. I mean, seriously, I've been on the phone with you for hours.
I want to know, what I want to know is, are you loving me too?
Can you let me speak? I don't owe you anything, and I'm doing this to try to help you. I'm doing this because I'm a nice person.
Yes. You don't owe me anything after 9 months.
Lord, listen to me. Lord, listen to me. Listen to me, okay? The term madly in love, we're going to define it. And I'm going to tell you how to know that you have it, okay? Are you in a mindset where you can be receptive?
I'm listening to you.
Or are you going to be receptive? I know you're going to hear it, but are you going to be receptive?
No. What are you telling me?
Oh, gosh. You're only going to be receptive. This is something you want to hear. Listen to me. Madly in love comes from spending years building a life with someone, building someone, being face-to-face. First of all, you have to believe. For madly in love to happen, two people have to spend time face-to-face. There is an intimacy that can only be built when two people are face-to-face. Now here's how that applies to you. When you meet someone, let's just say Jen, because you said you're already attracted to her, so let's use her as an example. When you meet Jen, and you take her out to dinner, and you have a great time, and you drop her off, and she looks into your eyes, and she smiles. That's really nice, and that's a great feeling, and that's really exciting, and that's what you should want. But that's not madly in love. It's... Okay, Lauren, if you're not going to be receptive, I'm going to hang up and just call you back on, like, Tuesday or Wednesday, because I'm really trying my best to help you. Like I said, I could have blocked you. Lauren,
my opinion of the last 9 months has been really helpful.
Lauren, I'm trying to help you so that this kind of stuff does not happen anymore, and so that you don't put women in positions where they feel like they've got to...
Really? You're going to blame this on me?
No, I'm not blaming this on you,
man. What does he know about me?
Boy. Do you want to hear about madly in love, or do you want to keep asking me?
No, I don't want to hear about madly in love. Madly in love with him, so much so.
What?
You're madly in love with him so much so. I'm going to let this guy believe. I'm on. I'm going to let this guy believe for 9 months that I'm his girlfriend.
Lauren, you cannot be somebody's girlfriend when you have not met them. That's what I'm
saying. Yeah, why were you?
Lauren, I wasn't. It was a fantasy that you had. I'm trying to...
For 9 months, 8 to 10 to 12 hours a day, you're madly in love with somebody else. Don't spend that kind of time with another guy. And let that guy tell you I love you.
Lauren, I never said it back.
No, you never said it back. I knew that was a problem. And I understood.
Yes.
You also told me you wouldn't say it back until we met.
Lauren, but it's not like I meet you and then I'm like, oh my God, I'm in love. No, that's not how it works, Lauren.
No shit, that's not how it works. Well, at least I put my heart into it, my honest heart.
But Lauren, that's what I'm trying to tell
not
you.
Fake bullshit. You didn't waste 9 months of your life.
If you didn't waste 9 months of yours, because you know what?
Really?
Because you know what?
I could have gone out on fucking dates. I didn't because I believed I had a girlfriend that I weren't going to cheat on. Nothing.
Lauren.
Little did I know, she was madly in love so much so with some other guy and fucking him every night.
Oh, boy.
Jig, how grateful.
So now you see why I didn't want to answer your question?
No, because you need to let me process this shit. Have you won the answer to not? You're taking it, by not answering it, not being truthful with me, you're taking away my choice. What do you honestly feel about me?
Can I say something to you?
You can. You always cut in on me anyway.
If anybody else, anybody who is any of the members of your church or whatever, had talked to you and you had convinced yourself that you were in a relationship with them and whatnot, let me tell you exactly how it would have went down. You'd have done exactly what you did with me to them. Every single one of your conversations, every single one of them would be online. Every single one of your new pictures would be online. Every single one of your new videos would be online. Every single one of your abusive voicemails and text messages would be online. And that person would not have spent 1 second trying to help you better yourself. Much less sat here for several hours trying to do it after the fact.
Well, you allow me to act like that. Thinking that you were my girlfriend.
Well, I don't think
you were madly in love so much so. Tell me that. You're living with.
I don't.
Tell me that your brother's living with you. Tell me that you, when we first met, you were single and you lived alone. Then your brother was moving in with you. Then there's a doctor. Then there's a neighbor. Then there's his neighbor's cousin.
And they.
I don't know any of that is right.
And they were. Any of that. They are all people in my life. It's just that I changed what they do.
Yeah. You changed your brother drastically to somebody that you're fucking the last 5 years. Don't you see something wrong with that? Just because everybody else online is dishonest, you really have to be dishonest too? Hey, that I thought so highly of, might not have met, but I spent fucking hours and hours and hours on the phone with every friggin' day. Bragging to my mom and Tony and Wendy how great a person that you are. And all through the fucking bullshit I had to go through with my probation officer, and my counselor, my therapist. Begging them to believe in you, to give you a chance. Not see anything wrong with that? Fucking hell I have gone through. All the fucking times that I cried my ass off over the phone with you on the phone, while you were laughing while I was bawling my ass off because of thinking you were the fucking doctor or somebody was too close in your fucking life and tearing me apart. That shit is right. All those hours on the phone with you, every fucking day, meant something to me. Nice to find out that they didn't mean shit to you.
Everything's gonna be okay.
Huh?
I said, everything's going to be okay.
Really?
Yes.
And how do you figure that?
I've told you, I don't think that you were listening, but I did tell you.
You told me what?
I've told you that everything's going to be okay.
How do you figure?
Because I truly believe that you're going to find someone in Maine. And I truly believe that you're going to be really happy.
Well, I truly believe I'm going to find somebody too. Obviously, it's not going to be anybody in Maryland because one that I thought was being fucking real with me. Madly in love with somebody else. So much so. And I was nothing but a fucking game to work. Nice to know I can be your entertainment.
Well, this is not entertaining me, okay?
No, didn't have to. Been your entertainment for the last 9 months.
Well, that is not entertainment either.
Really? All them hours every day?
I enjoy talking. I'm not using you for entertainment, if that's what you're saying.
No, what about the last 2 months?
Oy,
I didn't do this shit. You did.
So,
I don't feel bad about anything because I know I was being honest about everything. Let me ask you a question. How do you really feel when you were saying that shit to my mom about shit that I had said to you?
I wanted her to know so that she could help you.
you want her to know that not long after that, I could find out that you're madly in love with some other guy, so much so. Now I don't mean shit. I just had to make sure my mom knew. But you want to help me.
Okay, so then if okay, then let's go with that. If I didn't, then why am I still on the phone with you?
Still trying to figure out how you've tried, how you've helped me for the last 9 fucking months.
Okay, well, if I'm...
You just didn't.
Okay, well, then, if I'm this evil person, why am I still on the phone? Why haven't I just hung up?
I don't know. You feel bad about... last 9 months? That's about sleeping with anybody when you really fucking die to live with?
I feel that now, or I thought that now, you might be more receptive to the stuff I was telling you in the beginning.
You didn't realize that you might be a backlash at all the shit you've done.
What are you talking about?
You didn't realize that I rehashed everything. Make you really see what really happened.
What are you talking about?
Talking about all the time we spent together.
What about it?
Being nothing but bullshit to you, and it was actually something to me.
I'm glad that I provided comfort for you.
And you're glad that you let me believe that your brother was living with you. I'm glad that you let me believe that you weren't fucking anyone.
What do you want from me, Lauren? What do you want? I mean, like, seriously, what is the point of saying all this?
I want you to tell me what the fucking point was for the last 9 months of lying to me. The last 2 months of the stupid fucking bullshit you've done. You need an explanation because it makes no sense. What do you find that actually helped me?
So that's how you would react if I told you that I was in love with him.
That's how I'd react, because it fucks my head up.
And how would you react if I told you that I wasn't?
I would still want answers to those questions. About how you really feel about me. Did I put my everything into something that's fucking in my head? I try to make sense out of everything. You're madly in love with him. It's just the same thing as the fucking Amanda James did. That's where it is. Especially when you knew the Amanda James. Why would you do it to me?
First of all, Lauren, I doubt that Amanda James spent this much time trying to talk you through your issues. That's thing one. Thing two,
Well, you don't have to doubt it, because she did.
I know she didn't. So...
been 2.5 years with me fucking on my head.
Okay. But, Lorne, why... Well, I'm not even going to ask that, because I...
Ask whatever you want. You have every right to ask every question to me, too.
Why would you continue this online stuff, Lorne?
Why would I continue the online stuff? Is that what you just asked me?
Yes, why?
If you really want the answer to it.
Why you would continue the online stuff? Yes, please tell me.
You already know the answer to it.
Why?
I figured out a long time ago with Gene. Help me figure it out. Help me to figure it out.
What?
Because I was scared to be face to face, so I kept you at a distance. Whenever I blew up at you, it's because I was scared as hell, and I unconscious a while, and actually this guy in this other class helped me figure this out. I unconsciously or subconsciously, whatever, I can't remember, subconsciously push people away when I think I'm a 3-month fuck up. That's what those were. Because I knew the time was getting close. But subconsciously, fuck everything up. So that way I could set it back again. And he challenged me to not fuck up the 3-month deal we had.
So do you think that now that you know that about yourself, that you can have a real face-to-face relationship?
I know I can.
How?
Somebody helped me figure it out, what the hell I was doing. Now I pay attention to it. I have bothered me because I did that all that time.
Do you think that you can confidently approach Jen and know that, you know, you might get scared, but that you have to keep, you know, pushing forward?
I could, but I don't want Jen. I might think she's cute, but I don't want her.
Why not?
I don't know. I don't know.
Well, do you know that you don't have to, like, be, like, madly in love with her, ready to marry her in order to take her out a couple times and see what happens, right?
I know that.
Take her out. You don't have to be madly in love by the first date.
I don't want to take her out.
What do you want?
What do I want?
So what do you want?
What I want is you to be face to face with me and not madly in love with him, but madly in love with him so much so I can't do anything about that. I gotta find somebody different. Why are you madly in love with him?
Lorne, I need you to move forward.
Just answer my question, please. Honest.
I need you to move forward.
Be just honest with me. You need to move forward. I'm going to move forward either way.
Good.
So I need to know which direction it's going to go and how it's going to be played out. If you're not madly in love with him, and you have feelings for me, I need to know that so we can figure things out of how we're going to work everything. When we're going to meet, what we're going to do until we meet, we know everything. I don't like having a fucked up mind of what's going on with what.
honesty is always the best way to fucking go.
I want you to move forward. I can't.
I want you to be.
I can't bear the thought of you not being with someone because you're waiting for me. I need you to move
forward. I'm not going to wait for you. I need you to be honest with me. I don't need you to tell me something just so you can see what my reaction is going to be. I need you to be honest with me. I don't know about you. I'm glad you did that so you could see how my reaction would be. That way you could see everything that I was feeling.
I need you to move forward.
I need you to be, I'm going to move forward either way.
I need you to move forward with me as a friend and with someone else.
I need you to be honest with me. Are you honestly madly in love with him? Or are you, did you just tell me that see what my reaction will be? Are you honestly madly in love with him or not?
I feel like I'm in a weird spot because I can't.
You're not in a weird spot. If you never want to meet me, tell me.
I just.
I'm asking for honesty. That's all I'm asking for.
And I'm being honest. I need a friend, and so do you. And I want you to move forward.
We still need to be completely honest with each other, whether we're friends or not. I need you to be honest with me about everything.
I am.
And tell me, are you honestly madly in love with him, or did you tell me that just to get see what my reaction would be? Are you honestly madly in love with him or not?
No.
You're not.
No.
Good. No, you didn't. You didn't. Why you been living? Why have you been living for 5 years?
We're not going to discuss my living arrangements.
No, I'm trying to be a friend right now. I
don't need that, though. I don't need that. I don't need that aspect of a friend. I'm trying to
get you to see what the hell is wrong with you. You know, why are you doing that if you're not happy?
I'm not trying to discuss that. If this is about you moving forward, it needs to be a discussion about that, not a discussion about who I live with and am I happy or anything like that.
You being happy is important to me.
Okay, well, I would be happy if you move forward without me.
Well, I want you to answer this question.
What?
Do you never want to meet me?
I would like to meet you one day. But, I mean...
Then that's me.
It's not... What?
That's me.
I can't hear you.
I said, then that's me.
But it's not going to be about, it's not going to be a romantic thing, though. It can't.
It can be. Until we have everything figured out, what's going to go where.
Okay, that was funny. No, seriously, though, no. You need to find somebody you need.
We need to meet.
You've literally come full circle, as they say. You've brought us right back where we were. No,
we haven't come full circle. When we meet, that'll be full circle.
When we meet, that'll be as friends.
That'll be as friends, but I'm not going to shut sex out.
Okay, well, I'm glad you at least found it funny, but no, seriously.
You should have known. You should have known that was coming.
Let
me make sure you understand that right, though. That would be your choice, but I wouldn't shut it out.
You're such a gentleman.
Yeah, I know. It's taking you 9 fucking months to realize it.
Now, well, I was being sarcastic in that statement. Now, as I said.
Why was you being sarcastic?
Listen to me.
I think that is very gentlemanly. About how you feel.
Yeah, so. Yeah, so your goal is to find someone else outside of me.
There's no question.
I'm sure there would be. Okay, go ahead. But
is there anybody else besides me?
Who?
Huh?
What are you talking about?
Is there anybody else?
Anybody else where? What do you mean?
You're not madly in love with him.
Lauren, but this is why I didn't want to answer that question, because it didn't work. It really didn't work. I answered the question, and...
So, listen, stop trying to throw shit away.
Lauren,
the last 2 months, you were acting really weird to me. That's why I want to know. Is there anybody else? No.
I'm here.
The last 2 months you've been acting weird to me. Is there anyone else?
Hold on a second. That's this girl who's talking to me. Okay, what again?
The last 2 months, you've been acting weird to me. Is there anyone else?
Lauren, no. But what I'm telling you is that you need to be with someone who's in your state. That's what needs to happen.
Regardless of anything, we still need to meet.
I'm telling you, we don't have a relationship.
No, just have feelings for each other.
We don't have a relationship.
No, we just have feelings for each other.
But see, that's why I didn't want to answer that question, because either way I answered it, it puts me in a bad situation. And so we have a friendship, we don't have a relationship though, okay?
Yes, Sadie.
What?
I was talking to Sadie. Bob Brown. No, we don't have a relationship.
And we're not going to.
We really never did have one. Even though I thought we did. You saying we're not going to?
Because you're going to find someone where you are.
You're saying we're not going to, and you don't know that. You don't know what's going to happen in the future. You don't know how I'm going to feel in the future.
Oh, God, I can't do this anymore.
Answer me honestly with this.
What?
Do you have honest feelings for me?
What?
Do you have honest feelings for me?
I'm trying to think of how to answer that eloquently.
Well, it's just yes or no answer. Either you do or you don't. Be honest about it.
No, Lorne, stop.
At what? Don't want to know things I should have known before? You knew these questions were going to come, so they're not a surprise to you. You certainly can't blame me for wanting to ask them. You knew I wasn't going to hold back on asking them. You've gotten to know me that well. Best thing that we have ever had is that we are everything. All right, let's still problem now. I'm not for now. The way you don't get so stressed out.
I'm here.
Okay, let's stop problem on that. You know, you don't get so stressed out.
But you're not hearing what I'm saying, and
I'm hearing what you're saying.
Okay, so what am I saying then? If you're hearing.
You know, tell me if I'm right. One of you does love me.
You want us to
be friends. About what?
Yes. Hold on. Okay, start over again, because you said that first part too fast. Start over again.
Part of you does love me. That you want us to be just friends. So that I can find somebody up here.
That's perfect. That would be perfect. That is perfect.
And I write on everything you said.
Yes, absolutely. That's perfect.
Honestly? Am I honestly right on everything I said?
Yes.
If a part of you does love me.
Oh, good God.
I'm going through it again. So I know you're not just saying yes, so I'll shut up and move on to the next topic. As well as where the word honesty comes in.
The main part is that I want you to find someone else. You and I can be friends. That's the main part. That would be wonderful.
But the other part is, out of your love.
Yes, absolutely. Yes. Mm-hmm. And I want you to find someone in Maine and be happy and live happily ever after.
And you know it's me about part of your love.
Good God. Are you that desperate, Lauren?
Nope. I'm just wanting an honest answer. You mean I'm like that desperate?
Why?
After nine friggin' months? I'd like to know.
Yes, absolutely, yes.
Okay. Now you can listen to what I'm saying. Whatever I do is my choice. Just because you want me to find somebody in Maine, that's my choice.
I knew this was gonna come back. Okay, go ahead.
Well, I'm can't say I'm not lying about it because it's my choice what I do.
Okay, so here's the thing. If it is your choice if you find somebody in Maine, it's my choice if I find somebody in Maryland, and that's what I'm going to seek to do, and I encourage you to find someone in Maine.
Well, I'm going to look, too.
Please, absolutely.
But I'm not going to run out and have sexual right off the bat. Are you?
You know what? What I do with my body is my business. What you do with yours is your business. And you know what?
But it makes me back off, though.
If you swing from a chandelier and land on somebody's pussy tonight,
what?
I said if you swing from a chandelier,
it's what? I think I had. I was cutting in at the wrong time. Sorry.
Okay, if you swing from a chandelier and land on somebody's pussy tonight, I will high five you.
I won't do the same for you.
You know what? But here's the thing, though. You guys do what you want to do. Everybody's entitled to do what they want with their bodies.
Do the same for you, because I'm being honest. I don't want somebody else where I want the only one to be.
But see, oh, God.
But I know what kind of disease you want there.
You know what, though?
That's why I won't be a male slut.
Well, yeah. all that is notwithstanding. The only thing that matters is that you just go and you get back out there.
Well, I still need to meet.
One day, yes, but you know what? That has nothing to do with this. Right now, I'm just like.
Yeah, but we still need to meet as soon as possible. I've got my probation officer down my neck. I've got my therapist down my neck. And my counselor down my neck. With a lot. It's all because we haven't met.
Like I said,
I'm not even supposed to be talking to you. If I tell them that I'm talking to you, I'm not going to be in a good position. It's not a joke at all.
I don't think it is at all. I agree.
But if part of you loves me, you need to dig that part out and
Help me out here. Help us out.
But there is no us, though. That's the only thing.
There isn't us. That if we're gonna be continually talking, even we need to meet. So they're not down my neck. That's not me. Puts me in an extremely bad position.
Well, you tell them what you just said to me, and that I agreed or whatever, and you tell them that, and you'll be fine, okay? Like I said,
I'll be fine. When my probation officer didn't come back and tell me, the words that he's going to say is, you said you weren't going to talk to anybody over the internet again. A long distance.
Well, I don't know what to tell you there. I've never had a probation officer or anything like
that. You've never had to deal with the stuff that I'm dealing with.
Yeah, but I mean,
just because you say something, it sounds easier on your end. But for me to go to them and say this shit, it's not so easy.
Like I said, I don't know what to tell you there. All I know is just I said what I said, and
what you can say is we'll meet.
But I don't
have to go through this bullshit so that we can talk without me getting in trouble.
Like I said, I don't know when that can happen.
It's going to have to happen soon. I'm left with no choice. After 9 months, I'm left with no choice. I tell them right now that I'm talking to you on the phone. I'm right back in a bad position again. And it really sucks that they asked me. I don't have a choice, but I have to be honest with them. Ooh. I could be fucked.
I don't know what to tell you there, but
there's something for you to think about. Part of you loves me and want to continue talking, even. You already know what the only solution is. There's nothing I can do about it. I guarantee you I am worth meeting. I know you are.
Well, thank you. I'm sure when that's going to be able to happen.
Is that really October 30th?
Yeah.
At least now I know where you want to be. Right. Oh, God.
All right, so, I mean, I I'm very serious when I say that. Anything about us being in a relationship anymore, okay?
I don't know why you're repeating that.
Because I have to with you. I really have to with you. And I don't want to have to say that ever again. I find myself repeating a lot of things with you.
You find a what?
That I find I end up repeating a lot of things with you.
Oh, yeah. Some of it's... Sometimes I couldn't believe my ears.
No, that's where I am with that.
Now on. We don't hold anything back from each other at all, right?
What?
From now on, we don't hold anything back from each other at all, right?
In regards to what?
Anything. There's no reason we can't be completely honest with each other about everything.
We're just friends, though. We're not going to tell each other everything.
Yeah, well, we can hold some things back, because... Now we know both of us don't really want to know quite everything. There's something I'll never take away from you, though.
What?
There's something that I will never take away from you, though. There is something that I will never take away from you.
What is
that? I'll never stop telling you that I love
you. I don't know how to respond to that.
You don't need to. Why do you know I'm not taking that away from you? I was just looking for a response.
Okay.
So, you know, I have the right to take away something that you should know about. There's something I think you should know about me, too.
What's that?
My big toes are ugly.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to get you to laugh a little bit. You're awful. You can talk. No. In your answer to my question, am I going to yard sales today? Yes, I am.
You better go get some sleep so you can hit those sales.
I'm having the yard sale today.
You're selling some?
Yeah.
You better go get some sleep so that you can sell some.
I'm fine. What time are you planning on going to sleep?
Soon, I better hop off of here.
Are you being honest with me about soon, or do you just want to hop off of there?
Still on the phone with you for almost 4 hours, okay? I gotta hop off of here, okay?
I know, you get sick of me.
Alright.
Are you going to agree with that? You're not supposed to agree with that.
Wait, am I going to do what?
I said, I know you're getting sick of me.
Well, I did spend 4 hours saying the same thing.
I was trying to get off on a different subject now that we got all that crap over with. And have a little bit more fun.
That's very good. I'm hopping off here, though. I will share it with you that I found vegan chocolate-covered peanuts and they changed my life.
You found vegan chocolate-covered peanuts and they changed your life?
Yes.
How did it change your life?
Because they're amazing.
Did they give you cramps?
Hmm?
Did they give you cramps?
Cramps?
Peanuts give me cramps.
Weird. But yeah, they're...
I'm not weird either, but the reason peanut gives me cramps. Peanut butter doesn't, though. I can just sit there and eat a whole jar of peanut butter. That doesn't bother me at all.
Ew. I used to be able to do that, but now I get grossed out with the thought of that.
Now I get ice cream with my peanut butter and my ice cream.
Yeah, peanut butter and vegan ice cream. That's pretty good. Chocolate. Being chocolate syrup. All right. I'm going to hop off here, okay?
All right. What are you wearing?
No. Friends don't talk like that, okay?
Well, we can still know. We can still know what you're wearing.
Friends don't talk like that, okay?
Oh, God.
All right.
You're a geek.
I'll see you later, okay?
All right. I love you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.